Welcome to My Long Island TV. From Manhasset to Montauk, we've traveled our communities to bring you the following events. I'm your host, Waldo Cabrera. My Long Island TV starts now.
Welcome to the Nassau County Museum of Art. My name is Laura Lynch. I'm the Director of Education here at the museum, and we're very excited to welcome you here to the Glamorous Graffiti exhibition on the second floor of the museum. The Glamorous Graffiti aspect of it comes into it in the fact that many of these artists were considered outlaws in their community, and these are artists that all lived together in New York City in the late 1970s and 1980s. And later in their careers, they were embraced by the art community. Behind me, I have the artist Keith Haring. Many people might be familiar with his work, his very kind of clean imagery, often using the human body and figures. We are struck by his very kind of strong use of primary colors, and the figures are very clear. Often some of the work is very symmetrical, and some of the figures are actually kind of interdependent. We're looking at a very simple painting where he depicts a squatted figure. It looks very clean, like much of his work, but those kind of dripping marks almost add the hand of the artist. He allowed that to happen. It's not perfect, and the longer you look at it, there's less symmetry than you would imagine. This is another artist, Futura. So if we look at his work, it's in stark contrast to the work of Keith Haring. It's very abstract. The palette is much darker. There is a bit of spray paint happening, so there's the actual paint application's a little fuzzier and kind of more blurred. And in here we have these amazing kind of circular forms that keep our eye kind of spinning around on the surface of the canvas. In this gallery, we have the art of the artist Lee Quinones, as well as one piece by Jean-Michel Basquiat. In addition to these more completed paintings, we also have these drawings. The landscape format is really sketches for the size of a train. What Lee Quinones was famous for was he would climb up on the trains and be able to paint an entire train in one evening. So he would do these preparatory sketches ahead of time. We actually have one work by the artist Jean-Michel Basquiat. Basquiat was also discovered by the very famous artist Andy Warhol. So when we look at it, it's got a very dramatic application of red paint, very expressionistic kind of painting style, as well as these kind of Xerox of these images. When he was a small boy, his mother bought him a copy of Grey's Anatomy, which, you know, have kind of drawings, anatomical drawings, and you start to see some of those kind of references included, intestinal areas and also part of the jaw. One interesting artistic device that he used was actually printing or writing, then crossing them off. And that act of crossing something off actually makes you even more intrigued, because you're like, you want to know what it is he's crossing off. You know, he could have just taken this off the canvas. He decided to include it. We're here in front of the work of the artist Crash. He's brought to us three canvases. It's called a triptych. And you immediately see this kind of very large imagery that includes references to Art in America, which is a very important art publication, as well as comic strips. So people were very taken with the art of Crash, and later in his career, he was actually commissioned by Levi's and also Fender Guitars to do some of their graphics. Well, I'm so happy that I was able to share some of this wonderful work with you. I think it really captures a time period that many of our patrons might have had the opportunity to experience if you had visited New York City in the 1980s. You have the opportunity to come through July 10th, and you can visit our website, www.nassaumuseum.org.